Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 14 of my Resonant Rise Let's Play. So, like always, I will start off quickly showing you of what I did between the episodes. It isn't too much this time. And then I will get started onto the rest of the episode. And what you could plant is applied energistic stuff. I think it's finally time to start doing some applied energistic stuff, because all these chests are really making me, well, my life a bit difficult, and it would save me a lot of time just put it all into these, discs. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. And, what's this? I'm too distracted. Okay, so first of all, what I did is I quickly hit my engines behind this wall, cleaned up a little bit, also downstairs, underneath this thing, made it a little bit tidier, and all these cables running underneath this and all, I covered it all up. So it looks a bit nicer, as you can see right here, some covers. I'll maybe change this all later up to something else besides marble, or cobblestone, or stone. I don't even know exactly yet what, but I'm sure I'll figure out something. Not sure if I said this in, or showed you this in the previous video, but I got myself a sigil stand right here with a, light sigil. To light up this area, pretty nice. Has basically the same effect as a rev lamp, but this cool looks pretty cool. Then what I did is I hit my resonant energy cells down here. So basically, if I ever need one, I can just take them out, plunk them back, and they will recharge very quickly. And also, I changed from this energy output right there to underneath this wall, or underneath the floor, so you can see it. And it's connected to my entire system. So no longer have to worry about my power. And also, thanks to Finrod, I can very easily see on this graph when I'm using most power and when not. So basically, this is the amount of power that it is using. So currently, you can see it has 98% isn't being processed, and only 2% is being used at a time. And that also shows on this graph basically how higher, or the higher this thing is, the less power is getting generated or needed. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I think that's it what I basically did between the episodes. Yeah, I think that's it. So let's see. Yeah, applied logistics stuff. So I already smelted up some silicon just before I started recording, just to get it started, because it takes a while to process some stacks of that stuff. And let's see what stuff I need. First of all, I need an ME controller, which requires an advanced of these thingies, and I don't have that, so I'll go with this approach. Diamond, redstone, I'm sure I'll need a lot of these anyway soon, so I'll just make a stack of them, and also some of this stuff. So, let's activate my Coin of Fortune, disabled it quickly, did some messing around with some Tonkrev research, a lot of Tonkrev research. I might get into that in a few episodes, but yeah, not too much yet. Let's see, what did I need? Oh yeah, wait, diamonds. Diamonds galore. Then I need, let's see, what's it called? A cutting knife, it was. Quartz cutting knife. Iron, nether quartz, and some sticks. Not sure how many uses this thing has, so I'll just get a bunch. Let's see. Just get two of those for now. See how many I can get. I guess that doesn't work. Enough. Quickly get this stuff smelted. And then quickly check up what else I need. Yeah, it's going. Then I will also need some flux crystals, which are also rather easy. I'm mass producing all of this stuff because I know I will need it someday, and well, might as well do it now, right? So let's see. Flux crystals. Okay, that's nice. Then all I need is some iron. I already have that. And four of those things to get myself one ME controller. I'm going pretty much straight up to a big system and not just starting with basic ME chests and all that kind of stuff. Nope, I want it to be massive. Then I need some ME drives, which require basic processors. And they are the same but with gold. So I will need this recipe twice. Let's see. And of course I need more of these. Get my clipboard out so I don't have to take everything out of the crafting table. Cool. Get this melted up and I'll be back when it's done. Okay, I'm back. And it seems like the skin servers are having a bit of issues. Oh well. Okay, so I got myself the ME controller and I made myself two ME drives. I'll tell you why in a second. And I also got myself the basic processors cooked up. So let's see. Now what I will need is an access terminal. Or let's see, an access and a crafting. So I will need two of those. And this one, yeah. So let's see, two of these thingies, which aren't too bad. Let's see, can I craft them already? Yeah, two of these. Then I should make two of these, and also some of these. Then I can put this together, get two of those. Then the crafting thingy, which requires some of these. And what am I missing? Am I missing anything? Oh wait, redstone. Let's see. Yeah. Then should get two of those. Or wait, I only need one. Oh well, I'll use them someday. And of course a crafting grid. This should suffice. And there we go. Okay, so what my plan was to, for now, make this ME system right here in the wall. That's why I also moved some of this stuff. And yeah, basically I think this should work pretty fine. So let's see. ME controller can go... I'll place it right there. Then I can place the access terminal and crafting terminal right in the middle. And my drives can go one there. And I need to do something with this drive because I want to make one blast resistant ME drive. The downside is this thing only has three slots, but it will be blast resistant. So like basically if anything in case of an emergency must happen to this thing, I'm safe. And that's basically just what I wanted to have. So let's see, covered cable, it's just some wool and I need some obsidian. So let's see, it's a bit laggy today. Not sure if it's just my connection or what is the actual issue. But yeah, I'm sure it'll be fixed someday. And then seven of these. Then, I mean, does it show in any eye? No, simply do that. One blast resistant one can go right there. Pretty cool. So basically what my plan was to have all my excess stuff stored in this big drive, which I will probably fill up with 4K ones. And then this one, fill it up with some either 16K or 46K. So that basically allows me to store all my main resources and everything that I must need onto this drive. So yeah, that should be pretty cool. So the only thing I need now is power, I think. Simply go to the back of this thing and create myself a new line. Power, receive, and my system is up and running. Awesome. Is this stuff, how did I make it look? Yeah, this should be good. Now all I need to make are tons of drives. So let's see. If I look up the recipe for, first of all, these 64Ks, I will need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's see, I will need 3 of those. That's 9, 27. I will need 27 of those for each drive. Wow, that's rather expensive. Yeah, that's very expensive. I need a lot more of this stuff. You know what? I'll probably just craft these off camera and I'll be back once I made them all. And there we go. Two 64K storage buses. Awesome. So let's quickly plunk these in this thing. And yes, I got access to nothing. Too excited about nothing yet, but oh well. Let's see. What I want to do now is, I think, first of all, just move all my main things that I want in these 64K storage buses to there. So what's the best way to do that? I think it's import buses that I need for that. And import buses are not too cheap, but it will be worth it. Saves me a lot of time. Wait. Basic import bus, which requires an ME interface, which requires some of these matrixes. Matri. Nah, that doesn't sound right. Then I need one of these interfaces for now. Then get, let's see, a piston. Basic import bus. Then I need to turn it into a precision import bus. Awesome. And then I need to pick up all this stuff. Thank God I got my friend the force wrench. I think I just can do simply like that. Then move. Would this work? No. I gotta remember how this thing works. Wait, did I just create an export bus? Wow, I'm an idiot. Oops. I'm sure I'll use this thing someday. Let's see. Do it again. Import bus. This requires a sticky piston. I'm sure you guys must have been yelling at your screen. Or maybe you didn't even notice it. Who knows? I didn't. Why is it doing it? One sticky piston. Then get into my import bus. I'm low on cables. And low on glass. Then I need to finally do it right. Import bus. That's what I want. And then precision import bus. Yep. And face it the right way. Hey, there we go. Items flowing in. Awesome. That's exactly what I wanted. So then I can also quickly pick up these things. Cannot force rents a talentee with blacklisted items. Which item is blacklisted? Maybe this thing? Ah. That was easy. It's so cool to see all this stuff being plunked into the system. How are my drives keeping up? Oh, more than enough space. This should suffice for all my materials. And then the last one. And after this is done, I can finally move on to all these barrels. Because, well, might as well dump them in too. Oh wow, this thing is full of types, and this thing is filling up. Let's see. For this I need the Jabba thingy. This thing, the dolly. And yeah, the things are being pulled out of. Break it. Okay, this will take a while. Oh, my iron. Oh, the irony. Bad pun, sorry. Then the tin. Just quickly place them here for now, because I have a lot of iron to be processed. This thing will make it a lot easier for me to finally find stuff that I need, so. Isn't one of these a crafting terminal? Oh, yeah, wait, this is. Great. Then auto search, standard search, NEI, synchronized search. That's the one I want. Okay, break this thing. You know, guys, I'll just quickly do this off camera and I'll be back once I plunked most of my important stuff onto these drives. Okay, there we go. All my important stuff is in these drives. Awesome. As you can see, I got quite a lot of iron and let's see, what else stuff do I have a lot of? Copper, lead, osmium, quartz, quite a lot. Glass, of course. Basically, all the stuff that I have quite a lot of is what I placed in here. So, yeah, pretty cool. So, now all I need to do is make some more drives for these things. These things don't need to have such a high capacity of storage because they're mostly be for the storage of the different types. Because I will be having way more different types of that stuff than, well, the other things. So let's see, if I get myself some redstone. I forgot I can do it in here now. I don't need it. Let's see, applied energistics. Now I need to make, I can just stop this things also in there. Oh wait, I can do it like this, or not, no. Wait, yeah, applied and logistics, that's cool. I need to get myself the 4K drives, which are these things, which require three of these. So let's see, that's one, two, three. I'll make eight for now, let's just say that. That's 8 times 3 is 24. Then put them all together in a recipe. Let's see, why isn't this working? Yeah, like that. Get myself 8 of those things. And then I can get myself 4K. Storage cells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Awesome. Place all of these things right in there. It's almost full. Awesome. And then what I can get start doing is putting all this stuff, quick and easy, into the system. So basically, no more need for tons and tons of chests. At least, not for my storage, only for this stuff. As you can see, tons of my farm chests and everything. It is filling in this, I think, or not. Yeah, these things are taking priority, which is just what I wanted to have happen. Nice. Then, third one, which is wood stuff. And my fourth one, random junk. Then, let's see. Do I have anything in this? Yeah. And then this one? Nope. Then my tools, mob drops, random loot, and crap chest. That's also a nice reason to have all these 4K drives for my random crap chests. Because, well, like I said, way too much junk. Nope. And apparently this one wasn't empty yet. Nah, not as it matters. I can basically throw it all in there. Besides my clipboard. I need that thing. Another one empty. And my mob drops. Then more random junk. I said more random junk. What thing is blacklisted in there? What could possibly be blacklisted? I have no clue. I'll do it manually otherwise. And this one. My Dotcraft stuff. And my factory. So cool to just see all your stuff disappear into chests. Oop. Yeah, like that. Let's see, do I have anything in here? Oh, yeah, my scent and stuff. Oh, oops, I shouldn't do that. Because that isn't pretty much, well, not right. Luckily it didn't glitch this time. Usually it does glitch quite a lot if you do that, but oh well. Now, is this one empty? Yes. This one is not. How do I want to resolve this? I have no idea what is in it. So I'll just do it like that. Okay, I'll be back in a sec, guys. Okay, guys, sorry for that. So it looks like everything that I need pretty much is in here now. Awesome. All my random stuff. And of course, useful stuff. As you can also see, I quickly created myself two more drives because these things were filling up very fast. As you can see right there. Like, all of these are already full, and these three are filling up, or at least will fill up anyway soon. So yeah, if I ever need one more spot, I can quickly just add one in here. But for now, it is great. So what I can do now is move this Ender IO, and place it, I can just place it there to make it look symmetrical. And let's see, where's my ender face? Probably in this bag. I don't use it much, so this is basically my bag of stuff that I don't need to use regularly. And let's see. Great, I can access my access terminal or not. Well, this isn't useful. One does not have access to this access terminal when you use an ender face. Wow. Oh well. I guess I'll have to do something for that anytime later. So let's see. Since I'm not using this room anyway, might as well get these away. And place them. And this one. Where should I place them? Maybe just underneath these. Not under that thing. And then I can. Oh, I forgot one chest. I don't think there is much in it, but. Nah, it's empty already. Let's see. I guess I can pick this one up with. Oops. With a wrench, I think. Yeah, nice. So I pretty much will no longer need this room for any of that stuff. Awesome. This is also basically my necessary stuff that I need for big projects like my digital miner and stuff that's, yeah, basically fit together when I need them. Then my dictionary converter, which is basically just a, a forged dictionary thingy. Changes things up from one to another. Noel will know. Let's hope so. And then this work table can go. Goodbye, Mr. Piggy. I'll place you there. And this thing can go away. And this stuff will no longer need it. Ever. Yeah. And, wow, this room looks very dark like this. Maybe I should put some sigil in there. I believe I still have those from my magic thingy. Yeah. One sigil stand and one sigil of light. As you can also see, I got myself 14 activated division sigils, which is very nice. Where should I put this thing? Somewhere that... Yeah, I can't place it symmetrical to this room, so that's kind of annoying. Guess I'll place it on there. See if this will work. Will this light up this entire area pretty nice? At least a bit brighter. No? I guess so. Just place it in there then. I guess this should work. It should slowly fill in all these spots with light sources, so... I'll wait in a minute and see if that works. You see? It starts lighting up this area nice and fancy. So... All I need to do now, I think, is pretty much get all of these things out of the way. And then need to find a use for this room. If you guys have any suggestions of what I should put in this room, please let me know as quickly as possible before I start making anything into this room. So, yeah, I pretty much know what to do in there. So, let's see. Marble. Do I have any marble that fits in there? Nah. Quickly get myself 2 stacks of that stuff. And my chisel. Let's see. I will need the bricks. No? Wait, yeah. Oh, wait, this is all other stuff. I need the etched stuff, which is... This one. No, other one. The only downside with chisel is that it doesn't work too well with any eye, and it doesn't show me what it all is. And that is not very nice. Also, this trash can go away. Then I need... Wow, I really made a mess of this room. Some of this bricks. These ones to go right there, and then there, and then the rest is indeed just bricks. Awesome, nice empty room for further use. Now I got all my applied energistic stuff nicely kept away, and yeah, just pretty cool so I can finally access all the stuff. This can go there. Big crowded room. Nice and empty room. Let's see what other applied energistic stuff I can mess around with. If I quickly look it up, applied energistics. Let's see. I could go with the automatic assembler thingy, but I think I'll hold off for a further episode to do that, because it's also kind of a big project. To do that, so yeah, that's pretty much why. Let's see, what other stuff does this thing add? Controller, patterns, already have that, and patterns will need that for any further use. Transition stuff, power relay, no. Don't need that. Not sure what that is, nor that stuff, nor that stuff, nor that stuff. So much stuff that I haven't played with. I think this is all a bit new in the further newest episode, like spatial IO boards and quantum field ring. Oh wait, no, this is from a one that I already had. Okay, now I'll be back in a sec and see what I can do. Oh wow. I only just realized that I'm already over the 30 minute mark. Wow, it really flies by when you have fun and create awesome stuff. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I certainly did, and this will be a huge help for me, this applied energetic system, to finally, yeah, just have everything sorted and work a lot nicer. But yeah, other than that, guys, I hope to see you guys all next time.